internet browsing behavior of all internet users. Clicking was not necessary because simply the loading of the button was having the connection with the Facebook service already, and Facebook membership was not necessary. Now it is, or you just have to visit the facebook.com domain once in whatever, and then you're screwed as well. So never visit facebook.com if you don't want to have this. And of course, comparable systems, Twitter, LinkedIn, they also have these buttons, and they can do similar things with it. It's slightly different in these cases, but they are doing it. And then you can compile identities. This is a nice picture I have from Conti, and he is mapping the behavior of an offline individual, where you are being, and how this is connected with a digital system. So you have your home PC, you have a laptop, you have the same user account you're using, so that you can make a connection. We're traveling several countries, so you can find this. You can log on with your work PC, you can go to an internet cafe with the same account, something different. You can have the same IP address with different machines, and you can have unique search behavior, which is one of the numerous other tracking technologies available already after the cookies. And with this picture, you can see that it's really possible to really map all the whereabouts of an individual. What are the interests, also from where, at what moment. And data collection reaches far beyond the platform, because it's not only on Facebook, on the social media platform, but also over the entire web. This is facilitating profiling, profiling creation, and these are identities. This is an example, it was mentioned already before, and there's a talk about this tomorrow, Europe versus Facebook example with over 1,000 of pages of available information, and this was not including the like button materials even, so it's far more, I guess. And Google and Facebook are really seeing themselves as the digital identity providers. It's no longer that you need an offline passport to enter something, but you have a digital identity and they want to provide it. Google has admitted this end of last year, and Facebook is doing the same. They require the use of a real name. Google Plus doesn't anymore, but they did. And there is active control on this. This is an example from Facebook as well. If you are using a fake name and they discover it, and they have several technologies which they didn't want to explain to me, obviously, but they receive an email like, okay, we have blocked your account. If you want it back, provide us with your official identification documents. Send this to us, and then you have the opportunity to unblock it again. So there's active control, and the same is on Google Plus. I've skipped this for the for time reasons, but it's really interesting to look at the Gary Walker experiment. It's really fun. This was one guy in Google Plus who created two profiles with the same name and had all kinds of fake identity cards sent. And he was really showing that it was not really reliable.